Good morning students, welcome to the new subject, that is fluid power systems. In here I am mainly concentrating on the VTU syllabus. In here we are starting with the module 1, introduction to fluid power systems. My name is Veeresh Kumar K.S., assistant professor, Jain Institute of Technology, Davangere. Okay, fluid power systems. Before going to the brief introduction of fluid power systems, we have to understand why we use these systems. Mainly in nowadays or in industries, wherever we are using the power, so mainly there are two types of transmissions. One is mechanical transmission, another one is the electrical transmission. Okay, so transmission is nothing but we are transmitting the power from one point to the another point. Okay, we are transmitting from one point to the another point. Just for example, in the mechanical systems, we are using shafts, gears, chains, belts, etc., which are used to transmit the rotatory energy from one point to the another point. So we can say that is a mechanical transmission. So in electrical transmission, so what we are using transformers, we are using coils. So many electrical equipments which are used to transmit the power in the electrical form. So one more form of transmission is nothing but the fluid power transmission. So where we are using the fluid, that may be a liquid or that may be a gas. So what happens, we are using that fluid to transmit the power from one point to the another point. Okay, so that technology is nothing but the fluid power systems. You can see here, fluid power is the technology that deals with the generation, control and transmission of power using pressurized fluids. So in here they are saying fluid power is nothing but it is a technology where it mainly deals with the three form of work. One is generation. What is this generation? Generation is nothing but we are generating the power. Okay, so we are generating the power from the pressurized fluid. Next, controlling. So how we are going to control the pressurized fluid? So we are going to control the operations. We are to control some machines, so that can be achieved. So next is transmission. Transmission is nothing but we are transmitting the power from one point to the another point by using this pressurized fluid only. So these are the three important works which are going to be carried out in the fluid power system. So next, fluid power is called hydraulics when the fluid is liquid. So in here we are two types of systems we are considering in the fluid power. One is a hydraulic system and another one is the pneumatic systems. So in hydraulic systems we are using liquids. So it is a liquid form of fluid which are used, and that can be used to transmit the power. So in another system, that is the pneumatic system, so where you are using the gases in the form of fluid or working fluid. Hydraulic systems use liquids such as petroleum oils, synthetic oils and water. So these are the different liquids which are used in the hydraulic systems. So pneumatic systems use air as a gas medium because air is very abundant and can be readily exhausted into the atmosphere after the completing its assigned task. Okay, so what are the elements which we are using in the hydraulic system and the pneumatic system we are considering in here? Okay, so first see the power generation. So we have just defined what is a fluid power system. That is nothing but it's having the three elements. One is generation, controlling and transmission. So in here, for generation, you can see here the first video or GIF which you are showing in here, it is the hydraulic press. Okay, you can see here the hydraulic press which is using the hydraulic power to press a steel column. Okay, it is a steel column. So it is going to be compressed by using this hydraulic jaws, where it is operated with respect to the hydraulic power. So the hydraulic power is applied to the arm which is compressing here, and it is compressing the whatever the element, and you can see the power. So you can see the steel element is just bending like anything. Okay, you can bend like a cloth or paper. So that is the power of this hydraulic system. Next, you can see we are using this braking system. Okay, so in the cars you can generally see the hydraulic brakes. So what happens, hydraulic brakes, you can see this is the braking whatever the brake lever, where it is going to transmit that motion to this, and you can see there is a spring motion in here. It is actually a piston which is present inside this cylinder, small cylinder. When the brake is applied, that power is transmitted to here, and that braking is going to be applied to the fluid which is filled here, and it will be transmitted through this wire, black wire, and it will be pressurizing this piston to brake this whatever the rotating wheels. You can see the rotating wheels are stopped because of the pressure applied at here. So this is one of the application where the how the power is generated. So next, you can see the many equipments, the land digging equipment, construction equipments. So many equipments are there. There are, we are using many many types of devices which are mainly used to, you can see the power generation in there. So what is the important element which is generating the power in here? The important element which is generating the power here, we are using the mechanical devices to generate the power in the fluid. So we had, the fluid is normal state. When we are going to apply, we are going to increase the pressure of the fluid, then that pressurized fluid is used to the transmission or generation of the power. So that type it is going to be used. So next is the power controlling. So how you are going to control the power? So what happens, you can see the two diagrams. In here you can see this to and fro motion of this piston. So you can see there is an arm connected to here. It is moving to and fro. This is the motion which is observed in here. But how this is going to be controlled? So this is to and fro motion. Actually this is the actuator. So this to and fro motion is going to be controlled by one valve. So this is the valve. Okay. This valve is used to control the fluid flow. Can see the fluid is flowing from here one time and another fluid is flowing from here. So this can be controlled in different directions. So that controlling can be achieved by using these valves. Okay, so we can control the power, we can control the power by using the, by in the hydraulic system, by using the valves. Okay, similar operation you can see here. So one more piston movement is shown in here, and you can see there are the valves which are used. So that valve is going to be used to control the motion, to and fro motion of this whatever the system. Okay, so next, power transmission. So the power transmission is also one of the important parameter. So how you are going to transmit the power? So there are the diagrams which are showing in here. So you can see there are two pistons which are operated in here. One piston pressing it downwards, one piston just rise up. So what are the things which are happening in here? So the fluid which is collected here, it will be transmitted to through this whatever the pipes which are connected, or hoses which are connected here, it will be transmitted to the another piston. So it is going to be rise up. When this piston is pressurized, this piston is going to be rise up. What is the thing which is happening? So the power is transmitted from one point to this point, and this from here to here. So this transmission can be achieved. Okay, this transmission can be achieved in this whatever the fluid power system. So in here, one more diagram which is showing in here. Okay, you can see here one piston is operated in a linear manner. One small piston is pressurized in here. You can see the pressure is applied here, and whatever the fluid collected here, it will be transmitted to here, and piston move forward. And what is the amount of volume of fluid which is collected is equal to the volume of fluid which is pressurized, that can be equated in here. So like that, the power transmission can be happens. So these hoses are very important elements of power transmission. Okay, let's see very important part of this, whatever the fluid power systems. Okay, in the fluid power system, we first see the hydraulic systems. What is this hydraulic systems? What are the elements which are present in the hydraulic system? And it is the very important diagram. I will suggest take down this diagram for your notes, since it is going to be asked in your exams. Okay, see from here. Okay, so you can see this is the reservoir, or you can also call it as a oil tank. Okay, so it is a reservoir or a tank, so where the fluid is going to be filled. So next, you can see the fluid is moved to the next part. It is the filter. So where the filtering process is going to take place, if any impurity is present in the fluid, it will be filtered at this point. Next, this filter is going to be transmitted to the pump. So the pump is the mechanical device which is used to create this vacuum, and this will suck the fluid from the reservoir to the pump end. So what happens, this pump is going to be operated and it will be switched on through the motors. Okay, these motors are used to operate the pumps. So this motor is used and this motor is going to be electrified by the power supply. So what happens, this pump is going to transmit the fluid to the next stage, that is pressure regulator. So pressure regulator is one of the element where the pressure is going to be regulated. So what is the amount of pressure required for the next stage, that can be regulated at here and it will be transmitted to the next element. So next is the very important part of this system. It is the direction control valves. Okay, so direction control valves is going to be one of the important element which is used to control the direction of the fluid, pressurized fluid. So for example, if the fluid is moving from here to here, first stage, if it is moving from here to here, the fluid moves here and it will fill it at here and it will pressurize downwards. Just for a change, what we do, we will interchange the connection in this whatever the valve, control valve, direction controller. The fluid is moving from here to here. So what happens, the fluid moves from here to here and it will be filled and it will transmit it here. The fluid is filled and the pressure is applied upward and this piston move upward. So like that, the whatever the this direction control valve shift the lines and it will make the proper operation of this final stage. This is the actuator. So this fluid is next move on to the actuators. The actuators mainly consisting of these pistons and the whatever the arms which are going to be connected to some loads, where the load lifting and lowering of the load can be operated. So at the lowering stage, this fluid is going to be transmitted to the tank again. At another stage where the rising happens, this the fluid which is collected, this is also going to be transmitted to the oil tanks. So like this, this whatever the operation is going to take place. So you can see here 1, 2, this is the lever operation. The lever operation at 1, it is off stage. Lever operation at 2, it is a forward stage, and 3 is the return stage. So with respect to that operation, we are going to make the lifting or lowering of the piston in the actuator. Okay, you can see the explanation of those things. There are 6 basic components of whatever the hydraulic system. First is a tank to hold the hydraulic oil, a pump to force the oil through the system, an electric motor or other power source to drive the pump, valves to control oil direction, pressure and flow rate. Oil direction, pressure and flow rate, which are controlled by the valves. Next, an actuator to convert the pressure of the oil into mechanical force to do the usable work. Next, piping to carry the oil from one location to the another location. These are the 6 elements: tank, pump, electric motor, valves, actuator and piping. These are the common elements which are present in the hydraulic system. Okay students, you can see one more video of this hydraulic system. Okay, I think it is visible to you all. So this is the hydraulic tank. You can see this video and you can clearly understand what is the thing which is happening. The oil which is presented in the tank, it will be transmitted to the filters, then it will be transmitted to the pump, then the pump is operated through the electric motor, then it will be transmitted to the pressure regulator where the pressure is regulated. Next, it is transmitted to the control valves, and then it is transmitted to the actuators. Okay, you can see here the fluid enters in this direction. It will pressurize the whatever the piston to move upward, and the collector fluid return oil tank. Similarly, for to lower this whatever the piston or the load, what we do, the fluid is entering here, and you can see the valve which is lowered here. Okay, and it will pressurize the whatever the piston to move downwards. So like that, this operation is going to take place upward, downward. So by this controlling operation, the rise and lowering controlling of the control valves. Okay, next come to the pneumatic systems. Okay, so now till now which we have seen, it is the hydraulic system. In here now come to the pneumatic system components. What are the components present here? So you can see here. So in the hydraulic system, we have the reservoir or tank, but in here we don't have any tank because the air is abundantly available in the atmosphere. So we are going to suck the air directly from the atmosphere. So next it will move on to the air filters. What the air filters do? It will purify the air. So it will remove the dust particles or any unwanted particles. So it will remove here. Then it will be transmitted to the air compressor. So what is the work of air compressor? It will compress the air and it will increase the pressure of the air. So by compressing the air, the pressure of air is going to be increased, and this will be actuated by using the motors. This motor is supplied by the power, so it will actuated and it will transmit it to the compressor, and compressor compresses the air. Next, this compressed air is having a high temperature, means because of the compression, the particles which are present in the air, because of the compaction, it will increase the temperature. And it will be transmitted to the cooler. So air cooler, it will cools the high pressurized air. By that, after this cooling process, it will be transmitted to the storage reservoir. Okay, storage reservoir. It is just example. You can see in your home, so there is a cylinder, the gas cylinder. So where the high pressure air is going to be filled. High pressure gas is filled inside that. Similarly, the storage will be acting there like that. The high pressure will be filled here. And this pressure will be used to transmit it to the next level of control valve. So what happens if the pressure of this storage reservoir, if reaches the limiting pressure, then it will send the signal to the motor to stop, and by that motor is going to stop the process of compression, and the process of supplying air will be stopped at here. So if the limiting pressure reduces, it will again send the signals, and by that signal will actuate the motor, and it will compress there, and it will transmit it to the storage reservoir. So next stage, whatever the compressed air, it will be transmitted to the direction control valve. So what is the work of direction control valve? It will controls the direction of the whatever the fluids. It may be in the form of gas or it may be in the form of liquid. So this valve, it will be similar operation. If the actuation in this direction, the gases flow through this pipeline and it will be transmitted here, it collected here, and it will pressurize the piston to move downward. Okay, next, the collected fluid the gas which is in here, it will be transmitted here and it will be transmitted to the atmosphere. If you want to rise the whatever the piston, what happens? This direction control valve, it will shift the direction from here to here. The air passes from here to here and it will be transmitted to here, and it will pressurizes the piston to move upward. Okay, by that the load is going to be lifted upward. So this is the process which is going to happen in the pneumatic systems. It is the very important elements. So pneumatic systems having components that are similar to those used in the hydraulic systems. One is air tank. So in actually air tank is nothing but the atmosphere to store given volume of the compressed air, and compressor that is used to compress the air, an electric motor which is supplying the, it will be a mover for to compress the air. Next valve to control the direction of the and direction, pressure and flow rate of the whatever the gases. Actuators are nothing but the final devices where the actual output motion can be observed, which is similar to the operation of to the hydraulic actuator. Piping is the connections which are connected from one point to the another. So this is also one of the important component of a pneumatic systems. Let's see the applications of the hydraulic system or fluid power system. So there are many applications of this, whatever the fluid power systems. One by one we will see. First is the agriculture. You can see in the agriculture field we are maximum using tractors, farm equipments like plugs, movers, chemical sprayers, fertilizers, fertilizer spreaders. So these are the elements which are going to be used in the agriculture, and it can be formed by using the hydraulic systems. So some of the devices such as like plugs, in here you can see the plug, it can be lifted by using hydraulic system. In here the cylinder is there and it can be lifted upward and it can be lowered downward. So by that it can plug the land and it will used for the farming process. And many chemical sprayer operations and fertilizer spreader, it will require the compressed air or compressed fluids, so that can be pressurizedly spreaded to the farmland. Next is the aviation. So in the aviations also we are using the hydraulic systems, like landing wheels. You can see here the landing wheels. So these are the landing wheels. It can be operated by the hydraulic systems. You can see the flight is landing and you can see this, whatever the landing wheels are going to be lowered downward to the runway. And you can see the operation hydraulic systems. So it can be the opening of the wheels also operated, and it can also operate at the this is safe landing of this whatever the aeroplane. In the helicopters also we are using many things. In aircraft trolleys and aircraft engine test beds we are using the hydraulic systems. So next, building industries. Building industries, we have a lot of applications of hydraulic system. For example, this is the mixing concrete, whatever the truck we can call it as. So in here also for two, if you, this hooper is used. So if you want to take away that whatever the hooper for feeding that concrete, cement or jellies inside that whatever the concrete hooper, we require the hydraulic systems. So by that this truck is also one of the application of hydraulic system. So next is the construction equipments. Construction equipments are nothing but land digging equipments, earth moving equipments, excavators, bucket loaders, bulldozers, crawlers and road graders. These are all construction equipments. So you can see the diagram in here. It is the JCB which is used in here. But you can see the arms which are present in here. This will be operated through this whatever the hydraulic system. These arms are very important, where the hydraulic will be supplied, and because of the hydraulic pressurization it will move to and fro. So next, it is also used in the defense mechanism. This is the launching pad. So where the launching pad can be operated by the hydraulic system. You can see here, this is the cylinders and this is the piston which is moving moving according to the direction, and because of that the launching pad can be adjusted for the particular direction and can be launched. So it is having the many applications in the defense. Entertainment, it is having a lot of advantages in the entertainment, in amusement parks, entertainment ride likes, roller coasters. You can see the roller coaster, it's in here also. Many devices which are made up of hydraulic system, so it can be used in here. Next, fabrication industries. So fabrication industries are also having many applications. So you can see here the hand tools like pneumatic drills, pneumatic drilling operation, grinders, bores, riveting machine. You can see one of the riveting machine in here. This is the rivets, how it is going to be formed in here. This is the hydraulic press in the riveting machine. It is pressing that whatever the rivets at the high temperature and it will be making the rivet joint. Okay, so this is the similar operation which is shown in here. So it's also in the fabrication industry. So you can see in the conveyors, are many conveyors are used, and it can be used by, it can be formed by using the hydraulic systems. Food processing equipments, so wrapping, bottling, so many applications are there. Foundry, in the foundry applications also many more in here. So in here the automatic injection molding, which is also be having the hydraulic system, where it can be pressurizing that whatever the injecting whatever the fluid to form some machine. such as metals, injecting that metal into forming can be achieved by this automatic molding machines. Next, the material handling, such as jacks. We are using many jacks of hydraulic jacks, hose, cranes, forklift, conveyors. You can see on conveyor the video is shown in here. So where the sorting is happening, the sorting system is happening. So the whatever the products which are coming, it will be sorted at one direction, it will be sorted in another direction. So these are the applications of the fluid power systems. So let's see the advantages of fluid power systems. What are the main advantages of a fluid power system? So in here you can see the first advantage. Fluid power systems are simple, easy to operate, and can be controlled accurately. So the fluid power systems are very simple. You can see just hose pipes are used, some valves are used, and it can be operating some huge elements. Okay, so some huge whatever the output elements. So that by that you can see it is very simple, easy to operate. You can operate the heavy machines, okay, easily, and can be controlled accurately. You can control the accuracy of that operation. So that is the advantage of a fluid power system. Next, the multiplication and variation of forces. So you can multiply the force, okay, so you can multiply the force by using this whatever the hydraulic systems or pneumatic systems. What happens, since the water, whatever the liquid you are using in the hydraulic systems, it is incompressible. So if it is incompressible, so if you use that whatever the hydraulic systems, by applying some small amount of whatever the load or force, you can get the huge amount of force output. So that is called the multiplication of force. And variation of force, you can also make the variation of force, so that may be increased, that may be lowered by using the hydraulic systems, by changing the amount of output volume. Okay, the volume which is at the input and output volumes, which can be varied of that whatever cylinders, and by that you can achieve the multiplication. And multifunctional control, you can make the multifunctional control, means if you want to control the different devices. So if you have the to and fro motion of 3-4 elements, you can control by a single whatever the system, by varying the wall direction, and you can make the multifunctional control. Low speed torque is nothing but you can achieve the low speed torque by using this whatever the hydraulic system. Next, constant force or torque. Constant force means because of incompressibility property of a fluid, you can apply the constant force, constant torque to achieve the better results. It is economical. Yes, it is very economical compared to the other type of mechanical devices. Why? Because the fluid is, if water is readily available, so you can use that water for the application of hydraulic operations or some oils. So and the whatever the power required is also, means multiplication can happen, so it can be economical. But in the mechanical systems, if you want higher power, you have to apply some higher amount of energy, so then only you can get the higher amount of energy. So it is not that much economical compared to the hydraulic systems. Low weight to the power ratio. Okay, the low weight to the power ratio is nothing but you are applying whatever the weight, it is maybe a low weight, and the power can be obtained, it is more, this is going to be higher, so it is having the lower weight to the power ratio. The fluid power systems can be used where the safety is of vital importance. Okay, so wherever the safety is considered as the major importance, we are using the fluid power system. So next, see the transmission of power at static and dynamic states. Static state and dynamic state, there are two states of transmission. Static state is nothing but the hydrostatic systems uses fluid pressure, means the hydrostatic is nothing but static state where fluid pressure is used to transmit the power. Hydrostatic deals with the mechanic of still fluid and uses the theory of equilibrium condition in the fluid. The system creates high pressure and through the transmission line and control the element. This pressure drives an actuator The pump used in the hydrostatic system is a positive displacement pump. An example of pure hydrostatic is the transfer of force in hydraulics. You can see this diagram. It is the very easy example of a hydrostatic condition. What happens? The liquid is present in this whatever the system. So it is a small piston. This is small piston. This is the bigger piston. The small piston reciprocating in a small cylinder, and a bigger piston is reciprocating in the bigger cylinder. The fluid, the orange color which is shown, it is the fluid filled. You can see the F1 force is applied at here, and that whatever the steel fluid, it is transmitting the pressure to the another piston. Okay, it is transmitting the pressure from here to here by its pressure. So by that, the F1 force is converted to the F2 force in here by lifting the bigger piston. So this is the pressure transmission. So the hydrostatic condition where the fluid pressure is used to transmit the power. So next is hydrodynamic condition. So hydrodynamic condition is nothing but the condition where the fluid motion is used to transmit the power. Fluid motion is the important element which is used to transmit the power. So it is majorly in the turbines. You can see the power generating turbines, the fluid which is coming inside this, because of the fluid motion, the turbine rotates and it will make the power transmission from fluid to the electric power. It can be transmitted. The power is transmitted by the kinetic energy of the fluid. The hydrodynamic deals with the mechanic of moving fluid and uses the flow theory. The pump used in hydrodynamic system is non-positive displacement pump. An example of pure hydrodynamic is to conversion of flow energy in the turbine in the hydroelectric power plant. So this is the example. Okay, this is enough for this first class. We will discuss the Pascal's law in the next class. Okay, thank you students. If you have any doubts regarding this first class, you can ask in your WebEx session, or you can contact me through any WhatsApp or any contacting numbers. Okay, thank you.